Hi, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Have you ever wondered how 3D printer head can move to a known interval and then hold that position and repeat the movement over and over? Or have you ever wondered how does a CNC milling machine have such precise movements? It's all because of the stepper motor. This brushless electric motor divides a full rotation into a number of equal steps. They are typically digitally controlled as part of an open-loop system for use in holding or precision positioning applications. The motor's position can be controlled accurately without any feedback mechanism as long as the motor is carefully sized to the application. There are three main types of stepper motors. They are permanent magnet stepper, variable reluctance stepper, and the most accepted form of a stepper motor, hybrid synchronous stepper motor. First, we will try to understand how the variable reluctance type of stepper motor works, which is the simplest one. A variable reluctance stepper, as illustrated in the video, has six stator teeth and can be energized with three separated DC saws. The rotor is made of a stack of steel laminations. The rotor has a different number of teeth than the stator, in this case, four teeth. The arrangement has its role. And the rule is that only one pair of rotor teeth is aligned with the stator at a time. So how does it work? If you de-energize a pair of windings A and controller driver current to the pair of windings B, pair of B windings will attract the nearest pair of teeth. From the geometry, it's clear that one step size is 30 degrees. Again, if we de-energize pair of windings B and controller deliver current to the pair of windings C, pair of C windings will attract nearest pair of teeth. Again, because of geometry, it's clear that one step size corresponds to the angle of 30 degrees in the clockwise direction. In short, the rotor motor will follow this sequence, six steps to complete one revolution. The direction of rotation of the motor depends upon the sequence of supply signal given to each stator phase. We can improve accuracy to 15 degrees of this motor. So how do we do that? When pair of windings A is energized, the rotor is in this position. Next, when we de-energize the pair of windings A and energized pair of windings B, the rotor moves 30 degrees to this position. What happens when coils A and B are energized together? The rotor will come to a position between these two cases. In fact, it'll move 15 degrees. Next, if we de-energize the coil A, rotor will align with coil B. In fact, it will move 15 degrees. Next, if we energized coil C, the rotor will come to a position between coil B and coil C. In fact, it will move 15 degrees again, and so on and so on. This kind of operation is known as half-stepping. Half-stepping will be described in detail later in this video. The next type of stepper motor is permanent magnet stepper motor. The stator of permanent stepper motor is multipolar type. The rotor is a smooth cylindrical type. It's made out of ferrite material which is permanently magnetized. Hence, the motor is known as a permanent magnet stepper motor. Let us consider a permanent magnet stepper motor with a stator having four poles. Around the poles, the exciting coils are wound, the rotor having two poles. The voltage signals for different stator windings is given by using a driving circuit. When the input pulse is given to the motor with the help of a driving circuit, the motor starts rotating in step movements. When the supply is connected to winding of phase A, magnetic pole N is established on phase A. The rotor already consists of poles N and S. Due to the torque developed, the rotor starts rotating to adjust its axis of poles. As unlike poles attract, and like poles repel each other, S pole of the rotor is aligned with phase A of the stator. Now, the supply is disconnected from winding of phase A and is connected across winding of phase B. Due to this, the winding of phase A is de-energized and winding of phase B is energized. Therefore, the rotor further rotates and is aligned with winding of phase B. Similarly, winding of the phases C and D are connected to the supply sequentially. The rotor further changes its motion with an angle according to their respective pole axis. We can see that the motor of the rotor is in step movement. The major limitation of this type of motor is small step movements. Small step movements are impossible because the number of poles that can be made on the stator is limited. Permanent magnet stepper motors have higher torque capabilities than variable reluctance types, but at limited speeds, so they're best for applications that require low to moderate torque at low speeds. As we previously said, the most accepted and most commonly used stepper motor is the hybrid synchronous stepper motor. So, let's learn the working principle and explore the functionality of a typical 1.8 degree step-sized hybrid motor who has 2-phase and 8 poles. The hybrid motor has magnetized rotor with 2 steel caps, so one end of the rotor becomes the north pole and the other end becomes the south pole. The accuracy of this motor lies in the clever arrangement of rotor and stator teeth. So let's take a look and understand this arrangement first. Rotator has 50 teeth. To understand the stator teeth arrangement, we must first assume that the stator has 50 teeth as well. But stator has actually 2 fewer teeth than the rotor, so we are left with 48 teeth. Now let's arrange the 48 teeth into 4 group pairs like shown in the video. Green group of teeth is half aligned with rotor teeth. The teeth of the yellow group are completely unaligned with rotor teeth. The teeth of the red group are half aligned with rotor teeth, and the blue group are completely aligned with rotor teeth. Let's go further. Part of the rotor which is facing you acts like the south pole. The stator coils are connected as shown. As we can see, we have 2 independent coil groups. When group A is energized, the blue stator windings are magnetized in the pattern as shown. One pair of stator poles becomes north pole and the other becomes south pole. As the opposite poles attract, they'll be aligned and the same polarity poles will be unaligned. When the coiled B is energized, you can see what happens then to the rotor. Rotor is rotating by a small angle in order to align with the new north pole. It's clear that this angle is 1/4 of the angular pitch, so the rotor is rotated by 1.8 degrees. Now we again energized set A with the opposite polarity. Again, the rotor is rotating in 1.8 degrees. So when we repeated this process, we can achieve highly accurate motion of the motor. The step angle resolution can be further improved by half-stepping. It's important to know that the north end cap teeth are placed in between the south end teeth. In this way, alignment of the opposite polarity poles are guaranteed again. So this is the working principle of hybrid stepper motors. They are ideal for applications where precise movements and simple control are needed. Vibration of the step motor is one problem that we must deal with. Vibrations can cause problems, especially at low speed. So when a stepper motor makes a move from one step to the next, the rotor doesn't immediately stop. The rotor actually passes the final position, then is drawn back, passes the final in the opposite direction, and continues to move back and forth until it finally comes to a rest. We call this ringing, and it occurs every single step the motor takes. Similar to a bungee cord, the momentum carries the rotor past its stop point. It then bounces back and forth until finally coming to a rest. In most cases, however, the motor is commanded to move to the next step before it comes to a rest. The next thing that we must mention is how to control the stepper motor with stepper drives. There are several different ways of driving the stepper motor. 4 commonly used excitation modes for stepper motors are wave drive, full step drive, half-step drive, and microstepping. These excitation modes have an effect on both the running properties and torque that the motor delivers. The wave drive method has been simplified to better illustrate the theory. In the illustration, each 90-degree turn is representing 1.8 degrees of rotor rotation in an actual motor. In the wave drive method, also called the one-phase-on method, only one phase is turned on at a time. When we energize the phase A, phase becomes north pole. It attracts the south pole of the rotor. We turn off phase A and turn on phase B, the rotor rotates 90 degrees. 1.8 degrees of rotor rotation in an actual motor, and so on. Each time only one phase is energized. The wave drive has a 4-step electrical sequence to rotate the motor. Full step drive method. Once again, in this illustration below, every 90 degrees represents a 1.8 degrees rotation in an actual motor. If both faces A and B are energized as north poles, the south pole of the rotor will be lined up directly to the middle of two energized faces, two north poles of the stator. So to conclude, rotor south pole will follow this sequence and will always line up in the middle of two energized faces, two north poles of the stator. Full step drive mode provides much higher torque output because we always have two active coils at a given time. However, this doesn't improve the resolution of the stepper, and again, the rotor will make a full cycle in four step. For increasing resolution, we use half step drive method. This method combines two previous methods. In this case, we energize the A phase. The rotor lines up with the A phase. At this point, we keep the A phase on and energize the B phase. Now, the rotor is equally attracted to both phases and lines up in the middle. The rotor has rotated 45 degrees, 0.9 degrees of rotor rotation in an actual motor. Now we turn off phase A but leave on phase B. The motor makes another step, and so on and so forth. By alternating between one phase on and two phases on, we have cut the step angle in half. Remember that with a smaller step angle, the vibration is reduced. Rotor will make a full cycle in 8 step. However, the most common method of controlling stepper motors nowadays is the microstepping. Microstepping method drive is a way to make smaller steps even smaller. The smaller the step, the higher the resolution and the better the vibration characteristics. In microstepping, a phase is not fully on or fully off. It's partially on. Sine waves are applied to both phase A and phase B, 90 degrees apart, 0.9 degrees in a 5-phase stepper motor. When the maximum power is in phase A, phase B is at zero. The rotor will line up with phase A. As the current in phase A decreases, it's increasing in phase B. The rotor will take tiny steps towards phase B until phase B is at maximum and phase A is at zero. The process continues around the other phases and we have microstepping. This method will provide smooth motion of the rotor, decrease the stress of the parts, and increase the accuracy of the stepper motor. Because the phases are only partially energized, the motor torque is reduced, usually by about 30%. Also, because the torque differential between steps is so small, the motor sometimes cannot overcome the load. In those cases, the motor may be commanded to move 10 steps before it actually starts to move. I hope that this video about stepper motors was very educational for you. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this video. Watch the rest of my videos from my YouTube channel. Please consider to support me on Patreon. Thanks very much. See you on the next video.